Okay, we're back now talking about the CDIP, the Coastal Data Information Program, and the Southern California Wave Buoys. And one of the most important of these buoys is called the Harvest Buoy. It's off of Point Conception here, this big corner of the coastline, just west of Santa Barbara. Harvest Buoy is exposed to swells from all directions in the Pacific Ocean, so it's very useful for us to help us predict what's happening to waves as they come into the Southern California coastline. Turns out these CDIP buoys are designed to collect three types of information very accurately. They collect information on the heights of the waves that are going by. As the buoy goes up and down, it senses how much it goes up and down. They collect the period, the information on the swell period in seconds, and they collect information on the swell direction. And the height, period, and direction are shown by these abbreviations, capital H, capital T for time, and capital D for direction. Okay. And you'll see those abbreviations on the wave models, both here and in lab. What happens to that information then as it's transmitted up to a satellite and goes to a computer is that the computer every 3 hours generates what's called a wave model, which is a map predicting how big the waves are going to be in different places based on the swells that are approaching the buoy. And so the first thing to notice when you look at a wave model is this box here, which shows us that on this particular day, we have a deep water swell from the North Pacific with a height of 20 feet and a period of 20 seconds coming from a direction of 300. I'll explain that in just a second. A 20-second period swell with 20 feet in deep water is a really substantial wave. And just to go back to this figure for a minute, if you remember from the last video, remember the more energy the storm puts into the ocean, the longer the period. And a 20-second period is that comes from a really big storm. You don't get periods much longer than that anywhere, even in the Pacific Ocean. So these are big swells coming into our coastline, and they're coming from a compass direction of 300. Well, what does that mean? Well, you might remember from other labs that we divide the compass up into a 360-degree pi, where north is zero, and the numbers increase clockwise so that due east is 90, due south is 180, and so on and so forth. So if you have swells coming from a compass direction of 300, what that means is the swells are coming in like this, like that red arrow right there, okay, because that lines up with the 300. And now if I get the compass out of there, we can make some sense of our wave model. So there's our swell direction, and notice this color bar up here. This correlates to how high the swells are predicted to be in different places based on this particular swell. So you can see north of Point Conception, we've got really big waves breaking on the coast, probably more than 27 feet or higher. And that makes sense because that part of the coast is facing the direction the waves are coming from. But once you turn the corner from Point Conception, this part of the coast is sheltered from the waves. And so you get much smaller waves. But then by the time you get down here to San Diego, you see how the wave heights are picking up again because it's more exposed to that northwest swell. You can also see that the waves are smaller on the down wave sides of, for example, Catalina Island here and San Clemente Island and the Channel Islands. That's called a wave shadow. It sort of dampens the waves all the way to the coastline sometimes on the downwave side of the islands. You can see the waves are bigger on the upwave side of the islands, the side of the islands that's facing the waves. For example, look at the huge waves there off San Nicolas and off of San Miguel and these other northern Channel Islands. Here's another example. This is a different day, much smaller waves, and the dominant swell is actually from the South Pacific. So remember, you always look up here first. And here you can see that we've got a somewhat bigger swell from the South Pacific than the North Pacific, and that's the one that's really controlling what's happening. 4.3 feet high with a 17-second period coming from a direction of 195. Well, remember that the compass goes in a big circle, and by the time you get to 195, that would be over here. So the arrow there shows us the direction that 195 represents. And now we can make sense of the situation. You see these very nice swell shadows being cast by San Clemente and Santa Catalina Island. So we have small waves on the coast of Los Angeles, small waves along the coast here near Santa Barbara, but bigger waves in what we call swell windows, these openings between the islands where the waves can approach the mainland unimpeded. So bigger waves, say, along Orange County and in San Diego. So swell windows and swell shadows control a lot why we tend to have big days in some places and then small days in other places, and then maybe 2 days later it all changes around, okay, because those islands block or let waves through from different directions of the compass. Go ahead now and answer the pre-lab questions and then go on to the next video in the pre-lab exercise.